Welcome to my mom's channel, Spices and Flavors. I'm Archana Balasubramaniam and I will be your host for today. So we are going strong and we are at the day 6 challenge already. And today I'm going to be taking you through a very quick, easy snack recipe. It is makhana or the fox nuts or the lotus seeds. Let us take a look at how the makhana looks now. I now have the makhana here. I will be dry frying it in a kadai for about 10 to 15 minutes. Now I'm done sorting the makhana. How you check if the makhana is done is by taking one and pressing it between your fingers. It should make this crunchy sound. That's when you know that the makhana is done. I'm going to take a cup of it and then season it with the very simplest of the recipes, that is the Himalayan pink salt. Add salt according to your taste. And I'm also going to be adding a little pepper. You don't need to salt it for just a minute or two. And now the salt and pepper makhana is now ready. Starting now with my favorite recipe, I'm adding a little bit of jaljeera. These are all dry spices. A little bit of pani puri masala and chaat masala. I'm not adding salt here because the jaljeera already has salt. Mix this really well and now let's move on to the recipe. I'm adding a little bit of ghee and I'm adding the roasted makhana here. Add the dry spices immediately. Turn off the gas because it's gonna cook in the retained heat itself, otherwise the makhana will get charred. Mix it until it absorbs all the flavors. The pani puri makhana is now ready. I'm adding a little bit of ghee again. This is the kids' favorite Maggi masala. Add a little bit of Maggi. Just adding a little more ghee. Turn off the gas immediately. And then add your roasted makhana. The Maggi masala makhana is now ready. Now we're starting with the pizza flavor. For this, I'm taking a little bit of chili flakes. I have a mix of onion and garlic powder here. I'm adding a little bit of thyme, dried thyme leaves. I have a mixture of oregano and rosemary leaves. Mix it well together and you can use this as your dry spice. I'm adding a little bit of olive oil here. To this, I'm adding our dry spices, a little bit of salt, and I'm going to be sauteing it for a minute for hardly 10 seconds and I'm putting off the flame now. Adding the roasted makhana to this. Sort it till it absorbs the flavor and then your pizza flavored makhana is ready. I'm adding some mustard, curry leaves, fried gram, peanuts and cashews. All of these are pre-fried. A little bit of roasted desiccated coconut, turmeric. Keep sorting this so that it does not get charred. Add a little bit of chili powder. This is very similar to the puffed rice namkin that you eat. Turn off the flame. Add the makhana to this. And quickly sort it well. Add a little bit of salt according to your taste. And your namkeen makhana is now ready. Namkeen makhana is one of my go-to recipes. Don't you just love the color and the look of it? It obviously tastes delicious too. You should definitely try this. Now, coming to the most favorite recipe in my house, this is the caramelized makhana. So for this, I'm adding a little bit of ghee, some jaggery. Turn off the flame immediately because the jaggery will melt in the retained heat. Sort it for a bit until it melts. When the jaggery starts melting, turn off the heat. This is yet to start melting. The jaggery has melted. I'm quickly adding the roasted makhana. Keep sorting. I've turned off the flame already. Added sesame seeds. Make sure it gets coated well. The caramelized makhana is now ready and it is one of the yummiest recipes. You should definitely try this. Feel free to alter the taste by adding a little bit more of ghee or less of it, or a little bit more of jaggery or less of it. I'm sure you're gonna love this. Do try this out and tag my mom in the socials with the hashtag #HealthyRecipesWithShobha. And now you also know the drill. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.